Welcome to this presentation on tornadoes for the National Weather Service's Severe Weather Awareness Week. Tornadoes are violently rotating columns of air in contact with the ground in conjunction with a severe thunderstorm. Not all severe thunderstorms produce tornadoes. They come in a variety of different shapes and sizes, though these characteristics do not necessarily imply anything about how intense a tornado may be. They can form at any time of day, impact urban and rural areas, as well as mountains, lakes, or other geographic features. Tornadoes that occur over bodies of water are called waterspouts, as seen in the image on the bottom right. Tornado intensity is rated on the Enhanced Fujita scale, which ranges from EF0 to EF5. The Enhanced Fujita scale uses rigorous structural engineering principles to measure tornado strength based on damage produced. There are no ways to rate how intense a tornado may be before it does damage. Here's a map of the average annual number of tornadoes per state between 1981 and 2010. Notice how compared to the rest of the eastern U.S., tornadoes are relatively infrequent in New England, averaging about one per year. New York does average 9 tornadoes per year, but it is also a much larger state. Vermont and northern New York averages about 1 tornado per year, though there have been years where tornadoes have been more or less frequent than that average. There are two areas where tornadoes occur more commonly. The central and southern plains, which is referred to as Tornado Alley, due to the higher number of tornadoes that take place here, particularly during the spring and early summer months. Another relative maximum area is across the southern states. Tornado occurrence here is more common in the winter and spring months, with a secondary peak along the Gulf Coast in summer due to tornadoes produced by tropical cyclones. Each red line on this map shows historical tornado tracks from 1950 to 2011. By zooming in on the North Country, we find that tornadoes that have occurred here have been in the EF0 to EF2 intensity scale, shown by the small numbers with each track. So while it is fair to say that the North Country tornadoes are infrequent and usually of weak to moderate intensity, this does not mean that strong to violent tornadoes cannot occur here. Strong to violent tornadoes have happened in other portions of New England. So how do tornadoes form? First, you need a thunderstorm. Next, you need vertical wind shear, which is simply the change of wind speed or direction with increasing altitude. Often, but not always, both wind speed shear and directional wind shear are present. On the top right is an example of directional wind shear. You can see southeast winds near the ground shift to the south, southwest, and then west as we go upward in the atmosphere. Now here's a graphic to illustrate speed shear. The length of the arrows correspond to how fast the winds are, so wind speeds increase from the ground up. With strong winds above the ground and weaker winds near the ground, the wind speed shear produces a horizontally rotating tube of air. When vertical wind shear is present through a deep portion of the atmosphere, thunderstorms can produce severe weather for a longer period of time. Recent research has shown that tornado formation is more likely when strong low-level wind shear is present. Here's an example of a Scud cloud looking to the west over Lake Champlain. These are ragged-looking clouds that can hang underneath a cloud base or be completely detached from the cloud base itself. These are often mistaken for tornadoes or funnel clouds, but can form underneath harmless showers and have no relation to tornadoes. Another example of a type of cloud often mistaken for tornadoes are shelf clouds. These are intimidating-looking clouds that have a layered appearance with ragged cloud bases that can be very low to the ground. They are often accompanied by sharp wind shifts and are commonly associated with the leading edge of a heavy precipitation associated with lines of strong to severe thunderstorms. Tornadoes pose a substantial risk to life and property. Here in the North Country, tornadoes are difficult to confirm visually due to obstructed views of the horizon, such as mountains and trees. In the Northeast, tornadoes will also often be enshrouded by very heavy rainfall. Tornadoes can move fast and limit the time you have to head to safety. The National Weather Service will issue a tornado watch for parts of or all of the North Country when environmental conditions suggest a heightened risk for severe thunderstorms capable of producing tornadoes. Because all severe thunderstorms carry a very low risk of developing tornadoes, it is important to recognize that just because a tornado watch is not in effect, it does not mean that tornadoes are not possible. Tornado watches are used to make citizens aware that severe thunderstorms are expected to develop with a greater risk that some could produce tornadoes. Keep in mind that other forms of severe weather are entirely possible in areas under a tornado watch, such as hail and damaging winds. A tornado warning will be issued when a severe thunderstorm has produced or is capable of producing a tornado. Tornado warnings tend to follow a standard format, which includes the following information: a listing of affected counties, the warning valid time, or how long the warning is in effect till, the warning basis. This includes information on why the warning was issued, from what source, where the tornado is near, and how fast it is moving. A listing of cities, towns, or other geographic references in the warning. Additional threats, as tornado-producing thunderstorms often produce other forms of severe weather. Call to action statements, which are actions citizens need to take to protect themselves. It's important to note, tornado safety is entirely relative. No areas are guaranteed safe havens from tornadoes. Some areas are relatively more safe than others, but they are not guaranteed to keep you entirely from harm. Before thunderstorms develop, put into place an emergency action plan for your family and loved ones. There will be times when tornadoes will strike and your family may be separated. Having a common point of contact allows some peace of mind that your family is safe. If a tornado warning is issued, the key is to act quickly. Do not wait to see a tornado. Tornado fatalities are often due to flying debris, so protect yourself using any and all available means. Wearing a helmet and sheltering under flip tables, bed mattresses, or workbenches all offer some protection from flying debris. When it comes to adequate shelter, the best choice is in a well-constructed building away from windows in its lowest floor, basement, hallway, or safe room. Poor options for shelter include being outdoors, in vehicles, in mobile homes and campers. In fact, these situations should be avoided if possible. Remember, there are no guaranteed safe areas, especially in strong to violent tornadoes. Thanks for watching this presentation on tornadoes. For more information, visit us on the web, like us on Facebook, or follow us on Twitter.